Okay, in previous classes we learned about distance, time and speed. Let's see some numericals on these topics. The first problem was given distance in kilometers, that is 50 kilometers, time in hours. It was asked to find speed in kilometers per hour and meters per second. Okay, we know the formula, distance is equal to speed into time, but we want speed. So you can bring time to this side. This is for distance, this is for time, and for speed it will be distance by time. You have to remember these three formulas. Okay, for in this problem we need speed. Okay, that means speed is equal to distance is 50 kilometers and time is 10 hours. It is equal to 5 kilometers per hour. Okay, now it is in kilometers per hour. Now we want to find out speed in meters per second. To convert kilometers per hour to meters per second, we already learned that we have to multiply it with 5 by 18. So 5 into 5 by 18 is 25 by 18 meters per second. Now second problem. Here time was asked to find out in seconds. And see, here one thing you have to keep in mind when you see a problem, all the units are given and asked in same system or not. See, here distance was given in kilometers and speed also given in kilometers per hour, but time was asked to find out in seconds. So you have to convert given units into the required units. Now see, so time is distance by speed. If distance is 6 kilometers, that means 6000 meters, and speed is given in kilometers per hour. If we want to convert it into meters per second, to convert kilometers per hour into meters per second, we need to multiply it with 5 by 18. This is 18 2 is equal to 6000 by 10. Time is equal to 600 seconds. Because it is in meters and it is in meters per second, the time will be, units will, for answer will be in seconds only. Okay, this is the second. So now coming to third, time is given in hours. And it was asked to find out distance. So distance is equal to, we know, speed into time. That means speed into time. Okay, here speed is given in kilometers per hour, that is 2.5, and time is also given in hours, so both are in same, so no need to convert them. 0.56, distance is equal to 15 kilometers or 15,000 meters. Okay, see, a car started at a point A with a speed of 65 kilometers per hour in north direction and took a right turn after covering 40 kilometers, and then it traveled 50 kilometers and again took a right turn and covered 40 kilometers before reaching point B. What was asked here to find out? Find the time taken by car to reach point B, okay, from point A. And the second question, find the displacement. Okay, now let's see. The car started at point A. If it is point A, the speed of 65 kilometers per hour in north direction, that is north, south, east, west, so in north direction, and took a right turn after covering 40 kilometers. So after covering 40 kilometers, it took a right turn. So this is 40, distance is 40. 40 kilometers to take a right turn. And then it traveled 50 kilometers. First is 40 kilometers and next is 50 kilometers. Okay, that is, this is 50 kilometers distance. Okay, 50 kilometers and again took right turn. So right turn, again took right turn and covered 40 kilometers, again 40 kilometers before reaching point B. So this is its final position, to point B. To find the time taken by the car to reach point B, it was asked to find time. Okay, so time is equal to distance by speed. We know this formula. Okay, so now your time distance is, you have to calculate the total distance. Is 40, 50, 40, that is 130 by speed is 65 kilometers per hour. That means 65 twos is 2 hours. This is the time. Now again another question is, find the displacement. You already learned that distance is different from displacement. Here find time, we use total distance covered by the car with speed of 65 kilometers per hour. Now what is displacement? Displacement is the distance between the starting and ending point, initial point and final point. Now you can observe that these two length of these two paths is equal, so it forms a rectangle. So opposite sides are equal, so it will be again 50 kilometers. So what is the distance between initial and final point? It is 50 kilometers. So this is first answer, and second answer is displacement, 50 kilometers. Here total distance equal to 130 kilometers. Okay, have to know the difference between displacement and distance. Distance is the total distance covered by the car, and displacement is its difference between its distance between its final and initial positions. Okay, here see density. Problem on density. Which car runs faster among the following car? The three cars were given, and also there is a fourth car, and these cars are made with materials copper, iron and gold. Okay, which car runs faster? Okay, here it depends upon density, because we have a rule that car speed or velocity, it depends upon the mass of the car. You already learned that if there is so much mass, then the velocity will be decreased. It cannot gain more speed, more velocity. If you apply that phenomenon here, you have to find out the densities of these materials. I already told you in relative density chapter, we already found some densities for our calculation purpose in physics. So for copper it will be 8.9, for iron it will be 7.8, and for gold it will be 19.3. So now you can easily say which car runs faster. To gain more speed and velocity, its density should be very light, very less. So if you compare densities between these three materials, iron's density is less, so car made with iron, that is car Y, runs faster. And what if I ask you about the car which runs faster than car Y? Let's suppose it is car W. Can you find out any material which is lighter than iron? We have so many materials. So let's take it now, aluminium. The density of aluminium is around 2. So obviously, if you compare 4 cars and the last car is made up of aluminium, so it runs faster. So from these you have to know that car which runs faster should have less density. Okay, I hope you have learned something from this video. Thank you.